to me as a pastor of gender expansive kids in the Twin Cities, that they are less safe now than I was over a decade ago as a trans youth in the Twin Cities. Gathering here today shows those who want to make us fear and to go back into the closet and to go back into invisibility, it shows them that we are not going anywhere.
Those words were spoken in front of Hopkins High School this morning, where hundreds of people gathered to support a student many of them don't even know. The transgender student who police say was assaulted at Hopkins High School last week while leaving the bathroom. Right now, Minnetonka police are investigating what happened as a possible hate crime. And it's important that the police and the school district are calling what happened a possible assault, not a fight. As a fight would imply it was between people, and in this case, by both police and school statements so far, only one person was violent, and that was the person who allegedly attacked Cobalt. Here is Cobalt's story.
Last Thursday, Cobalt Sovereign had to go to the bathroom at Hopkins High School.
I was attempting to use the restroom. I actually did not get to until an hour later at the hospital.
The hospital, where she stayed for 2 days to repair serious injuries. Injuries she got after leaving the bathroom. She left the bathroom because...
In the bathroom, he had looked over the stall directly to where I was attempting to use the bathroom, and that is where he initially called me a in the first place.
The student that allegedly called her that repeated it several times.
I left the bathroom and I got it in myself to confront the kid verbally. He had no reason to have anything against me. I've never talked to him, never done anything negative to him. And I was insulted and then eventually hit in the jaw.
Cobalt's mother said videos shown to her today by police confirm Cobalt's story.
I saw just what she described. You know, she comes out of the bathroom and there's these three kids. They're clearly getting to her and around her. And then one of them hits her while she's just standing there, hit her very hard.
I was hit in the jaw, and at the time, one of my teeth exploded and there was pieces of my mouth. My jaw was broken in two places, one here and then one here, as you can see by this big bruise right here, as well as this tooth up, one of my molars in the top was just shattered. That was the tooth that was in my mouth. Sorry, I'm laughing. I'm just a little nervous right now.
You told me about your physical injuries.
Yeah, mentally, I did have a few nightmares after the events.
Are you ever scared to use the bathroom?
Less scared, more incredibly uncomfortable. It makes me very uncomfortable to be in the men's bathroom.
And yet she takes on that discomfort because of the world we live in.
I'd rather be uncomfortable than make other people uncomfortable by using the women's bathroom.
And as for her mom, discomfort is just a fact of life as a trans parent. And it resides right next to unabashed joy and gratitude to be Cobalt's trans parent.
Is it hard to have a trans kid?
Yeah. I mean, yes and no, it's great. It's so lucky, you know, we're really all lucky. Everybody's lucky who knows her. It might be hard for the world that I have a trans kid, but it's not hard for me.
For those of you wondering, yes, Hopkins High School does have a gender inclusive bathroom section, but Cobalt said those are often taken and they're out of the way of the rest of the school, and she just had to go to the bathroom where she had to go. As far as the investigation, police met with Cobalt today to show she and her mom the video of the alleged assault. From there, this case could go to the county attorney for possible charges. As far as the school, they told me the student who was accused of hitting Cobalt faced discipline immediately that exact day. And the policy at the school is to suspend a student in a fight. In this case, the district told me a suspension would mean that that student is done for the year.